It's a simple mechanism for protecting the data, a declarative technique with an easy-to-use PL/SQL interface. It leverages the existing technologies of virtual private database and data redaction that I've already demonstrated. The general technique, you define your policies just once. Define them once and apply them many, many times. You associate the policies with as many columns or tables as you wish. You can even deploy them to multiple databases. Now, there's a facility whereby you can develop your entire TSDP environment based on VPD and data redaction on a development system and then roll it out to a whole set of databases. Now, you can roll it out to your production database, to your data warehouse, to your testing systems, your QA systems, and so on. Define once, apply many times. But it is based on the existing technology. So what's the technique? You create a sensitive data type. That's little more than a logical name. You associate your tables and your columns with the type. You associate a policy with the type. And then you associate, and the policy connects you to the users. So the policy manages the users and their access to particular types. The type controls the data they can actually see. Based either on redaction or on VPD, and in many cases, I think when this takes off, it will be based on both. So, how do we actually do it? Well, the PL/SQL interface is refreshingly straightforward. So, I'll continue working in the SIS. I'll work on my Windows system here, and I'll work in the SIS schema. So, to begin with, first step, we create a type. So execute dbms tsdp manage is the first API we'll look at, and we add a sensitive type. And the sensitive type is just a label. I shall call it comp for compensation. I'm going to hide anything to do with money in the Scott schema. So we generate the type. Then we create a policy. Now, I'm going to paste in a pre-prepared statement on this because I'm tired of making typing errors. And I'll walk through it line by line. The critical procedure call is here, dbms tsdp protect add policy. When you add a policy, you in fact create a policy, give the policy a name, then specify which security feature is this policy going to be used for. And the options are redaction or VPD. On this occasion, I'm going to use a redaction TSPD policy because redaction is the new feature and I want to look at the new features more than the old ones. So the policy has a name and it's going to either redact data or filter access through VPD. What's the policy going to do? That depends on the options. And the options is a predefined data type that we have to populate. I've taken the most basic idea I can think of here. I'm going to specify an expression and a function. Right, my expression, syscontext, syssession roles, MGR. I'm going to simulate pretty much what I was doing before. So if you do not have the MGR role enabled, we will do full redaction. Right, so the policy has a name, it's applied, it enables one feature or the other, and then what's it going to do in this case? Full redaction, unless you are an MGR. Done. Then we have to associate the policy with the type. So I've created the type, associate the policy with the type. So execute dbms tsdp protect. And use the procedure associate policy. And I shall associate it. Which policy? The one I just created, redact full. And I'll associate it with the type that I created here. So that's a one-off exercise. Create the type, create the policy, connect them together. Then on demand, you associate the policy or the type with sensitive columns. So at this point, you might have identified 500 sensitive columns on any number of tables throughout your database. And that will be repeated calls, so there are ways around this, to execute dbms TSDP manage, and we add sensitive column. So we associate a sensitive column with the type. Well, which column? I'll have Scott.emp.sal. Associate the salary column with the sensitive type comp. Got an extra underscore there. So repeated calls to this procedure will set up the environment rather than what we saw before at the break, which is a much more complex environment that had to be configured individually for each column of each table. Now, connect. Connect Miller/Miller. Set role to none, disable his role. And now the redaction comes in. So what have I achieved? Well, so far, nothing that I couldn't really have done before. I've gone through almost the same exercise. I've had to create a type. I've created a policy with a function, with an expression rather than a function, that does redaction. And if you are not in that group, in that role, if you do not have that role enabled, you won't see the data. And I've associated it with only one table. But the beauty of it is that I can simply add more columns as I wish. Now, if I want to protect another column, all I need to do is add the column, associate a new column with it. For example, maybe I want to protect the com column, the commission. Add sensitive column, add sys, add the new column, and then re-enable the policy. Right, then we connect Miller/Miller, set the role, get rid of the role, run the query, and now we should see that that too has now been zeroed out. So the beauty of this then is that you can roll this out on a large scale, define the policy once, and then apply it as often as you wish. Now, see, I'm running a bit short on time, but let me move on. So what can we do with all this? Well, the end result, it really is very nice indeed. We define the policy just once, and then we can apply the same set of policies to many columns in many tables across many databases. VPD policies and redaction policies. It gives you a single point of control. It is, I should mention, nicely integrated with Cloud Control. If you have Cloud Control set up with application data models, then you can specify your sensitive columns there. And there's a discovery mechanism whereby you can point Cloud Control at your databases and in effect generate lists of sensitive columns to which the policies need to be applied. What can you use it for? It can help you conform to changing requirements of SOX or PCI or GAAP, your generally accepted accounting principles. Every time these regulations change and you have to apply different rules to how you redact data with redaction or how you conceal data completely with VPD, through TSDP, it gives you a central point of control for all this. And never forget, you can retrofit this technique to existing applications. Redaction with 12C or VPD with 11G, I as DBA go behind the back of the application software. No need for patches, no need for vast amounts of programming. I do it declaratively, and the programmers and users really have no idea what's going on. And I think this is going to be a very powerful facility already. It's already used in version 11, but it was difficult to use. And moving forward with 12C, I think it's going to be very useful indeed.